Hello students, this is Ritvik Dubey, your computer teacher. In today's video class, we will discuss about constructor overloading. Okay, the topic is constructor overloading. Constructor overloading. Okay, it is similar to method overloading. So what is constructor overloading? If multiple constructors are defined within a class with different parameter list, then that process is called as constructor overloading. Okay, so what is constructor overloading? It is the process in which multiple constructors are defined, in which multiple constructors are defined, in which multiple constructors are defined within a class, are defined within a class having different parameter list, having different parameter list. So what is constructor overloading? Constructor overloading वो प्रक्रिया है जिसमें कि एक से ज्यादा constructor, multiple means एक से ज्यादा constructors को define किया जाता है एक class के अंदर, जिनका की parameter list different होता है. So constructor overloading is the process in which multiple constructors, multiple means more than one constructors are defined within a class having different parameter list. When I say different parameter list, it means what? Number of parameters must be different. Number of parameters should be different. Okay? And or, second one is data type of parameters should be different. Data types of parameters should be different. Should be different. Clear? Okay. So different parameter list मतलब एक ही क्लास में बहुत सारे कंस्ट्रक्टर्स को आप डिफाइन कर रहे हो, इट इज अलाउड, लेकिन उनके पैरेंथेसिस के अंदर में सिमिलैरिटी नहीं होनी चाहिए, है ना. जैसे दो कंस्ट्रक्टर को डिफाइन करोगे, दोनों ही अगर नॉन पैरामीटराइज्ड है, इट इज नॉट अलाउड. ओके, सो यू विल हैव टू मेक डिफरेंट पैरामीटर लिस्ट. व्हेन आई से डिफरेंट पैरामीटर लिस्ट, इट मींस नंबर ऑफ पैरामीटर शुड बी डिफरेंट एंड और डेटा टाइप्स ऑफ पैरामीटर शुड बी डिफरेंट. Then only it will be called as different parameter list. Clear? Now let me give you one example. Listen. Listen. Public class, suppose demo. Okay. Now what is this? This is the non-parameterized constructor. See, the use of constructor is to initialize the non-static variable. But as of now, my target is to prove my points. Okay. So I will write here print statements by using system.out.println. Okay. So I will write here system. In place of system.out.println, I will write s.o.pl. But in examination, please do not write that. Okay? System.out.println npc. When I say npc, it means non-parameterized constructor of class demo got invoked. Okay, so this is one constructor. Assume this is one constructor. Then another constructor, demo, class name, constructor name same. Then I will write here int x and let me print सिस्टम डॉट आउट डॉट प्रिंटलन, पीएलएन मीन्स प्रिंटलन, व्हाट पीसी, पीसी मीन्स पैरामीटराइज्ड कंस्ट्रक्टर ऑफ टाइप इंट, वन पैरामीटराइज्ड कंस्ट्रक्टर विथ वन पैरामीटर, पैरामीटराइज्ड कंस्ट्रक्टर पीसी मीन्स पैरामीटराइज्ड कंस्ट्रक्टर विथ वन पैरामीटर, विथ वन पैरामीटर ऑफ टाइप इंट, ऑफ टाइप इंट गॉट इनपुट, गॉट इनपुट. ओके, नाउ इफ आई विल डिफाइन हियर अनदर कंस्ट्रक्टर डेमो इंट वाई, एंड इफ आई विल राइट हियर समथिंग, okay, and if I close the block of the class, then here I will get compile time error, here I will get compile time error. Okay, constructor demo int is already defined within class demo. Okay, you might be thinking, sir, variable names are different, now parameter names are different, here it is x, here it is y. No, different parameter list doesn't mean the name of the variables will be different. No, when I say different parameter list, it means number of parameters should be different and or data types of parameters should be different. Here you can see how many parameters are there, one parameter is there, and here how many parameters is there, one parameter is there. What is the data type of x? It is int. What is the data type of y? It is int. So it is not allowed. Here we will get error. Okay, now if you will write here float, then it's all right. If you will write here float apart from int, then it's all right. Okay. Now here I can write what system dot out dot println parameterized constructor with one parameter, parameterized constructor with one parameter of type float, of type float, of type float. Got invoked, of type float got invoked. Clear? Clear, huh? Now let me define one more constructor. Let me define one more constructor demo int x comma int y. Okay, and if I will write here system dot out dot println, what parameterized constructor with two parameters, with two parameters of type int, of type int comma int got invoked, got invoked. And let me close the block of this constructor. Here let me close the block of class. So in this class, how many constructors are there? This is the first constructor, this is the second constructor, this is the third constructor, this is the fourth constructor. How many constructors are there? There are four constructors. This process is called as constructor overloading. Okay, so let me repeat it for you. Constructor overloading is the process in which multiple constructors are defined within the class having different parameter list. Here number of parameter is equal to 0, here number of parameter is equal to 1 of type int, here number of parameter is equal to 1 but of type float, here number of parameters is equal to 2 of type int int. Is this clear? So this is called as constructor overloading. Now if I create, listen, if I create another class, public class, suppose user, public class user, you can give any name. Now within this class, if I define public static void main, please do not write like this in examination, okay? Do not use the shortcut, it will deduct your mark. Write it completely, public static void main string array args, capital S-T-R-I-N-G, string array space args. Now within this class, if I will create the object of class demo, then I can create the object in how many ways? See, demo dobj1 is equal to new to new demo. And if I will pass here 10 comma 20. Now you tell me, here the constructor is getting invoked automatically. Here the constructor demo is getting invoked automatically, because what is the rule? Constructor automatically gets invoked whenever a new object of the corresponding class is created. तो हम लोगों ने यहां पर क्या किया है, डेमो क्लास का ऑब्जेक्ट क्रिएट किया है ना. यहां पे इस लाइन में हमने क्या किया है, न्यू कीवर्ड का इस्तेमाल करके डेमो क्लास का ऑब्जेक्ट क्रिएट किया है. तो नियम क्या है, ऑटोमेटिकली डेमो क्लास का वो कंस्ट्रक्टर कॉल होगा जो कि 10 और 20 को रिसीव करने की कैपेसिटी रखता है. विच कंस्ट्रक्टर विल बी इनवोक्ड, द फर्स्ट कंस्ट्रक्टर, द कंपाइलर विल गो टू डेमो क्लास एंड चेक विच कंस्ट्रक्टर इज हैविंग द कैपेसिटी टू रिसीव द वैल्यूज 10 एंड 20. And here this is the constructor, no, this is the constructor, no, this is the constructor, no, this is that constructor which is what, which will be invoked. So the value 10, the value 10 will go to X, the value 10 will go to X, and the value 20 will go to Y. Sir, you are doing nothing with X and Y. My target is to do nothing with X and Y. My target is to prove the concept or explain the concept of constructor overloading. Okay. So if this line is getting printed on the output screen, it is proved that this constructor got invoked. But that is the reason why I have written here parameterized constructor with two parameters of type int int got invoked. So this line is the proof that this constructor, the last constructor of the class demo, is invoked. Clear? Okay, so in the first line we will get this output. Okay, in the first line we will get this output. In the first line we will get this output. Clear? Then if I create the object of demo like this, demo DOBJ, here I have taken 1, so here I will have to take 2. Okay, is equal to new demo, is equal to new demo, and if I write here what, 10.2. If I write here 10.2, I will get error. I will get error. Why? Because 10.2, any numeric value having decimal point is considered as a double type value. And what, this constructor whose parameter type is float doesn't have the capacity to receive a double type value. So I will have to write here 10.2 small f or capital F. Then only this 10.2f value will be received by this parameter, and we will get this as the second line of the output. We will get this as the second line of the output. Parameterized constructor with one parameter of type float got invoked. ये हमारे दूसरे लाइन में आएगा. ठीक है, देखो कंस्ट्रक्टर का काम प्रिंट करना होता ही नहीं है. ठीक है, लेकिन फिर भी मैं यहाँ पे प्रिंट क्यों कर रहा हूँ, जस्ट टू प्रूव माई स्टेटमेंट्स. मैं जो आपको समझा रहा हूं वो सत्य है, वो सही है. ठीक है, उसके लिए मैंने यहाँ पे क्या किया है, प्रिंट एलन स्टेटमेंट्स लिखा है. क्योंकि अगर ये आउटपुट स्क्रीन में अगर ये आ जा रहा है पहले लाइन में ये और दूसरे लाइन में ये, तो मेरा पॉइंट प्रूफ हो जाएगा कि ऑब्जेक्ट हम लोग जब क्रिएट किए पहला वाला, तो कौन सा कंस्ट्रक्टर कॉल हुआ, ये वाला कंस्ट्रक्टर कॉल हुआ. दूसरी बार जब इस तरीके से ऑब्जेक्ट क्रिएट किया और एक फ्लोट वैल्यू पास किए, तो कौन सा कंस्ट्रक्टर कॉल हुआ, तीसरा वाला, थर्ड वाला. क्लियर ना. ओके, नाउ इफ आई क्रिएट द ऑब्जेक्ट लाइक दिस, डेमो डी ओबीजे 3, demo DOBJ 3 is equal to new demo, is equal to new demo, and if I pass, okay, if I do not pass any, agar main koi bhi value pass nahi karunga, now you tell, yes, you are thinking right, this constructor will be invoked. Okay, this constructor will be invoked, and we will get this one as the third line, non-parameterized constructor of class demo got invoked. Clear? Now what is left? This one is left, I guess. Yes, this one is left. So let us do this also. Demo DOBJ4 is equal to what? New demo. New demo, let me pass one integer value 64. So the value 64 will be received by which constructor or which parameter? 64 will be received by the parameter of the second constructor. The value 64 will be received by the parameter of second constructor because the data type is int. So we will get this as the fourth line. So in first we will get this, in second we will get this, in third line we will get this, and in fourth line we will get this. Clear?
क्लियर ना?
ओके, सो दिस प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड एज कंस्ट्रक्टर ओवरलोडिंग. ओके, यू कैन टेक द स्क्रीनशॉट और यू कैन पॉज द वीडियो एंड राइट इट इन योर नोटबुक. ओके, क्लियर ना? फिनिश्ड. नाउ लेट मी शो यू द सेम थिंग इन माय लैपटॉप. कम,
यस, लिसन, ओपन ब्लूजे, क्रिएट अ क्लास, गिव एनी नेम, क्लिक ऑन ओके, डबल क्लिक ओवर इट, मैक्सिमाइज द स्क्रीन एंड देन कंट्रोल ए बैकस्पेस. सो वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट व्हाट? कंस्ट्रक्टर ओवरलोडिंग. ओके, PUBLIC, पब्लिक क्लास DEMO, पब्लिक क्लास डेमो. सो व्हाट इज कंस्ट्रक्टर ओवरलोडिंग? कंस्ट्रक्टर ओवरलोडिंग इज द प्रोसेस इन विच मल्टीपल कंस्ट्रक्टर्स आर डिफाइंड within the class having different parameter list. Okay, what is the meaning of different parameter list? I will explain to you. See, so this is the non-parameterized constructor. Okay, this is the non-parameterized constructor. Okay, let me write this. system, system.out.println, system.out.println, what? NPC. NPC means non-parameterized constructor of class demo, of class demo got invoked. Now if I copy this and paste it here and close the block of class, here I will get error. Constructor demo is already defined in class demo. Okay, why? Because here the number of parameter is zero. And here also the number of parameter is zero. Okay, so what is the definition? Constructor overloading is the process in which multiple constructors are defined within a class having different parameter list. When I say parameter list means number of parameters and or data types of parameters. Now let me increase the number of parameter int x. Now I will get no syntax error. Okay, let me write the message. Parameterized constructor, PC means parameterized constructor having one parameter. Okay, parameterized constructor having one parameter, of type int of class demo got invoked. Okay, now if I compile, I will get no syntax error. Yes or no? Why? Because here the parameter list is different. Here number of parameter is equal to zero and here number of parameter is equal to one. X is the only parameter of type int. So the message is parameterized constructor having one parameter of type int of class demo got invoked. Clear na? Okay, now let me copy this and paste it here. Now let me change x to y. Even then I will get error. What? Constructor demo int. Okay, constructor demo within parenthesis int. Int means parameterized constructor is already defined in class demo. Now you might be thinking, here we have changed the name. Yes or no? Here we have given the name to the parameter x and here the name of the parameter is y. So just changing the name of the parameter will not work. When I say different parameter list, it means number of parameters should be different. If number of parameters are same, then data type should be different. Samajh rahe ho? Parameter list different hona chahiye. Iska matlab samjho. Ya to number of parameters ko different banao. Agar number of parameters agar equal hain, to fir parameters ka data type change karo. So I will change the data type of this parameter y to float. Okay, now if I compile, I will get no syntax error. Okay, so parameterized constructor having one parameter of type float. Okay, now let me copy this and let me paste it here. Okay, so int x, int y. So what is this? Parameterized constructor having two parameters of type int, int of class demo got invoked. Compile, no syntax error. So in this class, you can see, in this class, how many constructors are there? There are four constructors. This is constructor one, this is constructor two, this is constructor three, this is constructor four. The first constructor is the non-parameterized constructor. Okay, that is, no parameters are available there. And in the second constructor, we have one parameter, that is x of type int. In the third constructor, we have one parameter of type float. And in the fourth constructor, we have two parameters of type int and int. Clear? Okay. Compile. Now, if I create another class, user, let me create another class, give any name, click on OK. Now maximize the screen, Control A, backspace. Okay, let me increase the font size. Yes, PUBLIC, public class user. Public class user. PUBLIC, public static void main capital STR ing string array space args. String array space args. Now let me clear one thing. See, we never write println statement within the body of constructor, because the use of constructor is to initialize object. When I say initialize object, it means initialize the non-static variables. But sir, why you have written here system.out.println? Just to prove my points. Okay, just to prove my points. Okay, now listen. Now here I will create the object of demo class, demo dobj1 is equal to new demo, and if I will pass here 10, 20, okay, 10, 20. So which constructor will be invoked? Which constructor of demo class will be invoked? This constructor. Which constructor? The last constructor, because this constructor has the capacity to receive two integer values. Why? Because this constructor has two number of parameters of type int, comma int. Okay, clear? Okay. Now let me copy this. Okay, let me copy this and paste it here. Now make it dobj2 and let me write here 10.2. Now here I will get error. Control K. No suitable constructor found. No suitable constructor found for demo. Look below. नीचे देखो, नो सुटेबल कंस्ट्रक्टर फाउंड फॉर डेमो डबल. क्यों? क्योंकि हम लोगों को पता है कि कोई भी न्यूमेरिक वैल्यू जिसमें कि डेसिमल पॉइंट होता है, बाय डिफॉल्ट कंपाइलर उसको क्या कंसीडर करता है? डबल टाइप वैल्यू. और अगर ये डबल टाइप वैल्यू है, ठीक है, और डेमो क्लास के अंदर कोई भी ऐसा कंस्ट्रक्टर नहीं है जिसका कि पैरामीटर का टाइप डबल है. नाउ यू माइट बी थिंकिंग हियर वी हैव रिटन फ्लोट, लेकिन डबल वैल्यू फ्लोट टाइप वेरिएबल में स्टोर नहीं किया जा सकता. ओके, सो वी आर गेटिंग एरर, वी आर गेटिंग एरर. सो यू नीड टू राइट 10.2f, स्मॉल f और कैपिटल f. नाउ इफ आई कंपाइल, आई विल गेट नो सिंटैक्स एरर. क्लियर? क्लियर ना? नाउ लेट मी कॉपी दिस एंड पेस्ट इट हियर एंड मेक इट dobj3. सो dobj3, लेट मी नॉट गिव एनी पैरामीटर. सो विच कंस्ट्रक्टर ऑफ डेमो क्लास विल बी इनवोक्ड? Which constructor of demo class will be invoked? Non-parameterized constructor. The first constructor will be invoked. Clear? Okay. Now, let me paste it once again and let me write dobj4 is equal to new demo and pass an integer value, suppose 64. Okay. Control K, no syntax error. So, which constructor will be invoked? Which constructor of demo class will be invoked? The second constructor of demo class will be invoked. Why? Because this constructor has the capacity to receive one integer value. Clear? Is this clear? Okay. Is this clear? Okay. Now listen. Now you can see. You can see both the screens. See. So this is the user class and this is the demo class. Within the user class, I have created the objects of demo class. Okay. Now let me explain you. See. So when we call the main method in the first line, okay, we are creating the first object of class demo, where we are passing 10 and 20. So the compiler goes to the demo class and search which constructor is capable to store two integer values. Okay, so 10 will go to x. Okay, 10 will go to x, and the value 20 will go to y. 20 will go to y. When we pass 10.2f, so 10.2f is actually received by the third constructor. And if we do not pass any value, then which constructor is invoked? The first constructor is invoked. When we pass 64, which constructor is invoked? The second constructor is invoked. I hope the thing is clear. Okay. आया समझ में? तो ऑब्जेक्ट क्रिएट करने से कंस्ट्रक्टर ऑटोमेटिकली इन्वोक होता है. और आज हमने क्या सीखा कि एक क्लास के अंदर हम एक से ज्यादा कंस्ट्रक्टर डिफाइन कर सकते हैं. इस प्रक्रिया को क्या कहा जाएगा? कंस्ट्रक्टर ओवरलोडिंग. सो व्हाट इज कंस्ट्रक्टर ओवरलोडिंग? कंस्ट्रक्टर ओवरलोडिंग इज द प्रोसेस इन विच मल्टीपल कंस्ट्रक्टर्स आर डिफाइंड विद इन अ क्लास हैविंग डिफरेंट पैरामीटर लिस्ट. इसको भूलना मत. मल्टीपल कंस्ट्रक्टर्स हम लोग डिफाइन कर सकते हैं, लेकिन ये ध्यान रखना है कि सारे के सारे कंस्ट्रक्टर्स का पैरामीटर लिस्ट डिफरेंट होना चाहिए. अब जब मैं कहता हूं पैरामीटर लिस्ट, इसका मतलब होता है दो बातों का ख्याल रखना है. या तो नंबर ऑफ पैरामीटर्स को डिफरेंट रखो, और अगर नंबर ऑफ पैरामीटर्स सेम है तो फिर डेटा टाइप ऑफ द पैरामीटर चेंज करना पड़ेगा. आया समझ में? क्लियर ना? सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट कंस्ट्रक्टर ओवरलोडिंग. क्लियर? Now let me show you the output. Okay, let me rub this all. Yes. So compile, no syntax error. Right click and let me call the method. You can see parameterized constructor having two parameters of type intent. Why? Because in the first line, I have created an object of demo class by passing 10, 20. So this constructor got invoked. Okay. Then I passed a float type value. Parameterized constructor having one parameter of type float of class demo got invoked. Then I have not passed any argument. So I have got non-parameterized constructor of class demo got invoked. Then I passed the value 64. Okay, which is an int value. So parameterized constructor having one parameter of type int of class demo got invoked. Clear? I hope the thing is clear. If there is any doubt, please ask me. Thank you so much for watching the video. Bye bye. Take care.